Hello, my name is Jeffrey Simpson. I'm the community manager here at Capcom Vancouver. And hopefully you did not hear that big loud bing that came on. That's going to be annoying. Yes, fantastic. I'm going to have to figure out how to mute Explorer. There we go. See, sometimes you start recording and then things happen. So, Explorer's muted. Hopefully you didn't hear the big bing, but I did in my earphones, in my ear holes. Anyway, I'm the community manager of Dead Rising and Capcom Vancouver. I'm here in Vancouver at the Capcom Vancouver Studios. And we are the developers of Dead Rising 2 and the whole Dead Rising series from 2 onwards, including Dead Rising 4, which is coming out this December. But before that, we've released the Dead Rising 10th Anniversary Edition. The original game's 10 years old, as of a couple of weeks ago, and so this week we've released new kind of upgraded versions of the game, Dead Rising, also of Dead Rising 2 and Dead Rising 2 Off the Record, on modern systems. So for the first time, you can get Dead Rising on Steam to play on your PC, and you can also get Dead Rising 2 and Dead Rising 2 Off the Record for the first time on Xbox One and PS4. So these are new releases of the games. They're $19.99 each, American, US dollars, different prices around the world. And we've been playing some Dead Rising at the studio here to kind of show off the new graphics. It's HD graphics, as well as show off the improved frame rate, and for people who aren't familiar with the game, kind of introduce them to the original Dead Rising. So I'm going to drop in the picture-in-picture here, because I've been playing a little bit earlier. So let's bring up the game. And so this is the original Dead Rising. This is right near the start of the game. We've got kind of Frank West has arrived at Willamette Shopping Mall. He's seen some crazy zombie antics going on outside, and he's entered the mall through the roof. We were playing this with some of the writers of Dead Rising 4 earlier this week. We kept not saving, which is a bad idea, and dying at a certain point, because it's really hard to talk and to interact with the chat. So we're here on Facebook, on the Capcom Vancouver Facebook page. This is where we're streaming, and so I'm going to be doing my best to watch the chat and kind of answer questions and interact with you in the chat. So if you do have any questions, ask them, as well as playing the game. So I'm going to take some pictures here, get some experience points. That was not a very good picture, apparently. Oh, no, it's not a very good picture. I am doing bad at this camera thing. So here we go. Let's go over here and see what these people have to do. These guys are well armed. So yeah, you get experience points when you take pictures of interesting things. You get different points for different types of pictures. It's one of the nice mechanics that Dead Rising brought into the game, and we're actually bringing back Dead Rising 4, because we're bringing back Frank West, the original hero, and he's got his camera. He's a photojournalist. He's covering the story of what's happening,
I can take him.
And taking photos gets you points.
Every time I come shopping with you, something happens to raise my blood pressure.
What do you mean every time? You don't even come home most nights.
And there we go. We got some pictures. So hopefully we will be able to beat Carlotto this time, because we did very bad the last time. It was very embarrassing to keep dying. But it's actually, in our defense, it's hard to play this game, keep talking as you're playing. And here we go. Here's the cutscene. Let's listen to this.
You! Stop right there! Do you
have any idea what you've done? Why did you summon me to this place? What are you planning?
Would you calm down? I don't even know what you're talking about. What the?
So, clearly Frank's never met a cranky old man before. Here we go. And this woman's able to throw off two young men who are trying to stop her from opening the doors and letting the zombies in. However much you love your dog, don't do this, people. This is not a good idea. And we do these streams over lunch, so you can see things like that and really get a good appetite for what you're going to be eating.
What in the hell are you people doing? Run! Quick, move! Get over here! Everyone, move this way! Quick, to the stairs! Move!
All right. Now, I've tried several times to save these survivors. They always seem to die, so I'm not going to worry too much about trying to save them. In fact, I can probably get some points if I take some photos of them being chopped on.
Perfect.
No. Except I want to avoid dying myself. You get different points for different things, like, for example, horror. Brutality. There's also, go. What? Oh, I'm getting chomped on myself. Come on, Frank, you can do it. Don't die at the first action scene of the game. God damn it. Come on, Frank. This will be very embarrassing. Also, I'm gonna try not to swear too much. But that's what I call a TV. It's a PG swear. Yeah. All right. I managed to survive the opening scene of the game. Games, to be fair, are a lot harder than they are these days. They used to be a lot harder. This was one of our problems, because everyone's used to autosave in game. Like, you get to a checkpoint and it automatically saves. We just kept going, and then we'd be like, oh yeah, we forgot to save an hour ago. Let's watch this. Let's watch this scene go down.
Others? I don't know. I hope they got away.
No. As long as those things are in the mall. We better not use this door.
What are you doing?
The air ducts. They'll get us back into the mall. And apparently, those things aren't smart enough to use the ducts. So they won't be a factor.
Wait a minute. You want to get back in there? What for? Hey,
nice camera. Are you a photographer?
As a matter of fact, I am. Frank West, photojournalist.
Could you show me some pictures, Frank?
You really seem to know what you're doing. Who are you guys, anyway? And what are you... I took that one near the entrance. That guy do something?
Nope. Thanks for showing me, though.
Hey, we're not done talking yet. Just who are you guys?
I'm Jesse. The man you saw earlier is Brad. That's all I'm authorized to tell you.
All right, so there we go. We met Jesse, Brad, and here's Otis. Yeah. Let's go see. So we gotta get some food. So I believe there's food in here. For example, there's an apple. Let's have this apple. So when you eat things in Dead Rising, or drink things, you get health. It's a pretty good game mechanic and makes some sense. And let's talk to her. She's not gonna tell me anything. All right. Anything in here? Can you do anything with these shoes? Nope. Alright, let's go. I'm gonna go, there's some, so the game comes with the DLC costumes, so we can put on some costumes here.
Alright.
Here's, Frank in a nice pink shirt.
Alright.
Blue. I don't like that tie, though. Let's see what this one is.
Alright.
That's stripey color is not good. I'm gonna stick with pink.
Right.
Alright, I'm gonna do that. This is the Frank I'm gonna be playing with here. I don't wanna go there. I wanna go. Let's go talk to Otis and see what Otis says. So in the chat, Terry is asking about the Games Breaker DLC for DR2 and whether or not we'd be thinking about including something like that in Dead Rising 4. That's definitely some cool DLC. We're not announcing that sort of granular details yet, but it's definitely, you know, obviously we're the studio that made DR2 and DR2 Off the Record, so we're definitely aware of that, and, you know, you never know what's going to happen. But it's nothing we're announcing. We're not really talking about DLC at this point, and we're not talking in great depth about stuff that that we kind of haven't shown on the various trailers we've released and in various interviews at events that we've done. And here we go. We are on the roof. So this is going to be our introduction to saving survivors, which is a big, big thing for the game.
Hey, anybody around?
Here is Jeff. No relation to me. So your wife's around here. Okay, let's go find your wife. Are you going to follow me or... No, you're going to just run around by the elevator. Okay. So I'm going to pick up some weapons. You can collect pretty much one of the revolutionary things about Dead Rising.
Mister!
When it first came out was you can use pretty much everything as a weapon of some kind. From the very useful, like a baseball bat. Baseball bats are obviously useful. They're the sort of weapons that... that you like to have around. To the not very useful. We will see some of the not very useful weapons later on today. Hi, Natalie. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. All right. So this is explaining how we, you know, move survivors around. So I can be like,
go!
Natalie, go stand over there.
Follow me.
Or I can say, come back here. Yeah. And I can give her a weapon, so I'm going to give her this weapon, just in case we... No. Apparently I cannot give Natalie a weapon. Oh, it is Joe Nichols, studio head. Hello. Do you guys want to jump on mic or anything? No. All right. I'm being photobombed.
Yeah, totally. That's a totally photobomb.
I don't know if you can even hear them.
No.
No. No, if you can hear... Anyway. People can't hear each other at this point. But. Alright.
We were watching you for a while, then we come and grabbed your party.
Alright, well, hopefully, I'm not embarrassing you too much.
No, I'm glad you didn't die in the opening scene.
Yes, that would have been embarrassing.
Really cool.
Yes. Oh, dear. Alright. Here we are. Natalie, follow me. Alright, here's Jeff again. Jeff and Natalie are meeting. Oh! Let's take a nice romantic shot. One of the things when we had Jeff Campbell, writer on Dead Rising 4, and Shannon Campbell, also a writer on Dead Rising 4, no relation to each other, or to me, or to anyone else. Well, I assume they're related to someone. One of the things they noted was, it's pretty impressive how video games have changed in that you look at this and there's not a lot of dialogue, or at least voice dialogue, like all this text we're reading. These days, if a game did that and it was just like, here's a bunch of text, or at least a AAA game on the level of Dead Rising, people would say, hey, that's not cool. We want to hear people's voices. Are you guys following me, or I have to talk to you some more? At least zombies can't fly. I mean, I could just leave them here. They seem safe enough, but it's probably smart to take them back to the safe house. Come on.
Follow me! Follow me!
That you couldn't really do that in a game these days. I mean, indie games, you definitely can. You know, a big-budget AAA game from a studio like Capcom, you wouldn't be able to pull off the, here's just a bunch of text and no voice acting thing for so much of this. Case in point, hi Otis. He's going to give me a info dump here. Otis is explaining how things work and where things are. And yeah, one of the great things I like about Dead Rising, it's funny, is that to save the game, you go to the bathroom, you take a pee.
Zombies, had a feeling you'd show
up. Let's let this play.
God, it's you. Look, don't sneak up on me.
Brad was attacked. I located him on the monitor. Oh!
It's probably just a sprain.
I've got to help Brad, or he's done for.
All right, fine. Give me your gun. Come on. I'm the reason you just got hurt. Let me help.
No, I can't let a civilian do that. That's against regulations.
Yeah, well, I don't think they had zombie-infested malls in mind when they wrote those regulations, kid.
You know how to use this?
Kinda. I've covered wars, you know. Look, after I'm through helping you, you and I are gonna have a nice little chat.
Well, that sounded threatening. Here we go. So we've got, yeah, as Ernesto notes in the Facebook chat, I've covered wars, you know, is the classic Dead Rising line. It's Frank's signature. Oh, you guys are with me. Oh, and Otis is phoning. Everyone is just bugging me right now. Jeez. Yeah, I've covered wars, you know, the classic Frank West line that... that basically everyone quotes. So where are we going? We wanted to go back. We didn't want to go here. Come on, you guys. All right, let's go back. Let's get out of here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Do we have to go through? We gotta... come on. I want to take you back to... Otis. Yes, I've just met you. I don't need to know who you are every time you phone. Is this? Oh, it's because I took. Is it because I took the elevator? Here we go. Come on. I think this should fix it. Maybe. See, I'm trying to drop these people off so they're not following me, because they're very killable, dieable. They're dieable people, and I want to keep them alive. Because at heart, Frank West is a good guy. He wants people to live. Here we go. Thank you. Alright, now we got a backup for Brad, so let's get back up here. Alright. I've leveled up. Awesome. So Brad seems like a sensible guy so far in this game. He's had the doors welded shut so the zombies can't get in. He seems to know a little bit about zombies. I think that's going to be useful. He's going to be a useful ally. Come on, Otis. Okay, cool. I'm trying to save Brad. Alright. Otis, I'm hanging up now. Goodbye, Otis. Not literally, Otis. I hope you survive this experience. But I also hope you don't phone me a lot. Alright, I'm gonna get a battery for my camera. I think, oh my. Okay. Thanks, Otis. You get to watch me navigate, man. Use. Aren't you excited? Oops, I don't want to use that. Come on! See? That's fun. Alright, what? Alright, well, I think this is the jewelry shop. Is there another one? Okay. Well. We're going to go outside for a bit. Or actually, I can probably do the cut from the same cloth. Or the photo photo thing up here. Let's go meet Kent. Here we go. Whoop. Hi.
Good.
Nice drama. Sorry, Kent, you're being a jerk. I gotta check on the chat. How are you guys doing in there? Alright, I'll stand here, so go ahead and take a shot. I've already taken a shot, but.
Good.
There we go. Alright. So here are the different kinds of things we get points for by taking photos. Brutality, drama, outtake, horror, and erotica. So let's see what we can take. Kent here, sorry.
Perfect.
Try a little harder, old timer.
Perfect.
You old sack of crap! Smile!
Perfect.
There we go.
Boring! Fantastic! Great shot!
Alright. Good. I'm glad you enjoyed that. Signature cool poses. Alright. Let's go, Kent. Let's get some pictures. You and me. These zombies, that's not important. It's honing our photography.
Fantastic. That's no good, man.
What? Come on, man.
Smile. Beautiful. Oh. That's no good, man.
Yeah.
I'll show you for real this time.
No, you weren't in the frame.
Perfect.
Come
on, man.
That's
no good, man. Fantastic. Great shot.
All right, move or something. Okay, here we go. Loading. I was loading up a scene, that's why.
Well, it's in focus. And the composition's okay, I suppose. Uh-huh. That ain't half bad. Okay, here comes the next one, Frankie. But first, feast your eyes on my work. Now this is my most emotionally moving shot. Now this is my sexiest shot. Okay. This is my most violent shot. Check it out. Okay, here's the deal, Frankie. You gotta go out there and take even better pictures than the ones I just showed you. You think you can handle that, huh?
Yeah.
I think Kent was kind of a jerk. I kind of hope he dies. No spoilers, but I really would like to kill Kent. Now I'm going to change clothes. No, I don't want a hanger. I will take a skateboard. But I thought maybe there'd be some clothes here. Apparently there's not. Okay, where are we going? We are... Skateboard broke. Alright. Here we go. Let's go save Brad. Run slowly through the zombified fields of Willamette, the Frank West story. What do we have? We've got chocolate milk. We'll use that later. We've got a gun and a baseball bat. I feel like we have one more thing. So if you guys see any good weapons I can grab, let me know. Also, if you have any questions or anything, feel free to drop into the Facebook chat. Assuming you're watching this live, a lot of people do watch it later on. Go, Frank, go. Go, Frank, go. Gun. Baseball bat. Whoa, zombie. I suppose I should be taking pictures. I think these are... That did not do well since we aren't zoomed in yet. That did better, but...
Yeah.
That zombie has a knife. Who gave a zombie a knife? Let's get this. Oh, that went poorly. Getting too close to these people. Let's get into the food court. Things are safer in the food court. Kyle is here, and he's saying, 10-year-long fan all the way from Texas. Thanks for releasing this game and for doing the live stream. Whoa, that scared me. I'll talk to you in a minute.
Your girlfriend sent me to find you.
Who, Jesse? Damn it!
Okay, we'll have to talk about this later. You know how to use that gun?
I've never fired at a person.
All right, I'll cover you from here. You need to stick to the shadows. Try to get close to the target, okay?
And what am I supposed to do when I get close?
Well, the best solution would be to shoot the guy. But if you can't do that, keep him busy dodging your bullets and stay out of trouble. Are you up to it?
I'm a lot better with a camera. But yeah, I'll give it a shot.
All right. Next time he reloads, I'll lay down a suppressing fire. I'm counting on you. Make your way over there. One, two, three!
All right. There we go. Whoa. Someone's shooting at me. It is Carlito, and he's up there. All right, Lydia. I realize, again, we have not saved. So, we keep making the same mistake. Oh, that is a... No, aiming... Aiming is hard. Going over here. All right. So as I was saying, I realized we haven't saved again, which was our problem earlier this week. Come over here, Brad. But I am doing better. No, this grenade's gonna. Thankfully, in a food court, we should be able to find some food. Like this yogurt. Get up. Get back over here, Frank. Where is this guy? Again, that's your camera, Frank. That was not a great photo. But I am doing better. I'm running out of bullets. Hopefully he can take a few more shots in the head, directly in the head, and die. Oh, I've got another 30 bullets. I had another gun. I remember that. The fast way of doing this is to get up onto the level there with him, and then just clobber him with something, but this seems to be the safe way, because I am still at full health, although I did eat one yogurt cup. Right between the legs. So anyway, back to Kyle. Thank you, Kyle. I'm glad you're a longtime fan. Glad you're tuning in. Hopefully you enjoy this. Carlito's going to run away. Like a magician, up into the sky.
He got away. Who was that anyway?
I don't know. Well, Thanks for your help. The name's Brad.
I'm Frank West, photojournalist. And right now, I'd rather have an explanation than your thanks, Brad.
Sorry. I've got nothing to tell you. Look. I don't know what Jesse told you. But as far as I'm concerned, we're through working together. So you cover your zombie story and leave the rest to us.
You guys are looking for someone here, aren't you? Hmm?
Who is that? Where did you take it?
You help me, I help you.
You're one hell of a journalist, aren't you, Frank? A hot-headed, underhanded, hotshot paparazzi with nothing better to do than to invade people's privacy.
I try. You got a point?
You win, Frank. Let's work together. Jesse and I are DHS agents. And yes, we are looking for the man in that picture.
You're with Homeland Security. Is that guy a terrorist or something? I took that picture in the entrance plaza. Right near the front door.
The entrance plaza. You're sure?
Hey! So do I have your permission to cover this story, or not?
And we're back. Brad's gonna run away, and we're gonna level up.
Excellent. Yeah.
The jump kick skill. How do I do that? Oh, anyone there? There's zombies in here. I don't remember that happening. You guys weren't here before. Who let you in? You're getting blood all over my pink shirt. Alright, let's get out of here. Come on, Brad. We've got places to go. Mysteries to solve. Photos to take. Garbage cans to throw. Again. Ooh. That seemed inappropriate, lady. Ooh, chainsaw. I'm gonna switch the baseball bat for the chainsaw. Right in half. This will be useful. Come on, I'm following Brad. Just mowing right through zombies. My chainsaw broke. Ooh. Anything good in here? I know, I have to keep up with Brad, but I'm shopping. Don't think... Apparently nothing good in here. For example, I was mentioning weapons that are kind of useless. Trees are kind of useless. So I'm going to leave the tree. And just get back to running. If you people have any questions, feel free to ask them. I'm gonna see if there's food in here. Ooh. Time is ticking away. So feel free to ask him in the Facebook chat. And we're loading screens here. Meanwhile, in London. No, that's not Big Ben, just to confirm. Oh, it's nighttime. That guy's fly is slightly undone. And his eyes are glowing. I think this means that they're going to get a bit more dangerous. Zombies scare me. I'm going to be frank about that. No pun intended. I was on a vacation in London when 28 Weeks Later came out, and I went to see that in the theater in London. And I did not sleep well for the rest of that trip because it was quite scary. Alright, let's go, Brad. It was quite scary, and I was like, oh my goodness, I'm in London. This movie takes place in London. I am freaked out. Also, I probably should save at some point. Because, as I've mentioned, not saving is a bad idea. Alright, let's go inside. Brad, do you mind if we find a washroom first? Brad, I have to pee. Brad. 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 Brad's not listening to me, guys.
Sir, if you could just kindly come with us, we can wrap this whole thing up.
No, I'm not leaving until you can
absolutely
guarantee
sir
me safe passage.
Just open
to
this gate. Just open this gate.
No.
It's for your protection. Just
I am not opening any gate. Thank you very much. I'm going to stay right here.
Dr. Barnaby.
It's safe.
Sir.
Thank you and goodbye.
Dr. Barnaby.
Brad is a terrible negotiator.
You can't just arrest him?
He turned down my offer to protect him. Said he isn't going anywhere until I can guarantee a secure route out of here. Jesse has a direct line to HQ. The first thing we need to do is to call for backup.
All right, here we go. Yeah, you're going to tell me some stuff I don't want to know, Otis. I just want to find a bathroom. You should never find a bathroom around a mall. Bathroom, bathroom, bathroom. Ooh, toy store. Two places I always go to in a mall. The bathroom and the toy store. I like toy stores. Alright. Frank is much too pleased, but I do like the fact that that mask matches the shirt. That was not planned, but it works out very well. So, Demon Frank. Ooh. How's our weapon stock? It's alright. I don't need weapons right now. Otis! Alright. So Otis, the security guard of the mall, is basically telling me to loot whatever I want. I really wish he would have told me where there's a bathroom. Come on, Frank. I replace this baseball bat. Just for a fresh one, because I've hit some zombies with it. These weapons wear out after usage. So I want to stay. Can I go in here? Nope. Need the meat. Where do I get the key? Okay, I'm going to just follow this arrow I assume it's going to take me somewhere useful, as opposed to wandering around a bunch of closed stores. But I am enjoying the mall music. I think that's captured nicely here. Oh, do I go up here? Yes. There's no way out of here from there, but where am I going? I'm just looking around, really. I'm trying to find a washroom. Let's see if the map tells me anything. Here we go.
Security room.
That's kind of where we want to go. So I want to go. Basically, I was going the right way, and then I mucked up. All right. I think. Let's just go back down and follow the arrow. Grab this shopping cart. There we go. Gotta stay away from crowds of zombies. I mean, this is a life lesson that you should be learning, kids. All right. Orange juice is good for the soul and the body. I'm gonna hold on to that. Ooh, that's the jump kick. Let's jump kick some people, Frank. Needs a workout. There we go. How's our stock weapons? I think I'll trade a juice for this. Oh yeah, I forgot. Right, so that's why people are being greater jerks than normal. Oh, we're back at the food court. Oh, that's right. We had to follow Brad. This is why I should have a better short-term memory. Don't want to hear it, Otis. Get off of me. Do they have any food around here? Apparently this food court has very little in the way of food. But at least the zombies aren't all by the door, so I can get out here. Good, 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 good. One of the things, if you're familiar with the original Xbox 360 release of Dead Rising 10 years ago, you'll notice the load times between levels are better. Oh. I really wish I would have saved before now.
right, brother.
All right, looks like we found our next contestant.
We're gonna take out that dude and snatch his old lady.
I don't quite understand why they were just walking around in this zombie-infested area, holding hands as though it was like a romantic, romantic Friday date night.
Anyone?
All right, I'm gonna see if I can save Sophie, I guess. We got some good music coming here. Seems like something I want a gun for. Actually, I'll wait till I get closer. Alright, now I want a gun. Sophie, come here. Come here. I'm trying to help you. I am not prepared for this fight. Now I have a picture of you guys. I'm totally going to turn that in to the authorities. Oh, I can hold her hand. Thank you. Excellent. Come on, Sophie. Come on, Sophie, get over here.
Follow me.
Hopefully she was close enough that she'll come in with me. Because I don't want to stay out there with those guys with the very... Oh, good. Come on, Sophie. Weird camera angle choice. Alright, where are we? Oh, we've got some visual glitching. We're just going to fix that. That's just on the stream. What are you doing, Sophie? Sophie. Come on. Sophie, hold onto my hand. Sophie. Sophie. Otis, not a good time. Also, Sophie, if you see any food on the ground or anything, please let me know. I would really appreciate it. I think we made it. I think we made it, people. I think we might get to a save point, which would be great because I don't want to do all of that again. What is up with that bee? All right, Sophie, are you here? Come here, Sophie. All right, Oz. Thanks, I really care. Otis, right now, I barely made it out of the mall. There's guys with a machine gun at Sophie.
Come on!
I'm not gonna hold your hand anymore, Sophie.
Good.
Oh, there's a zombie queen or something. Ooh. Anyway, come on. My point is, Otis, a lot's going on right now in my life.
Come on!
And I would appreciate it if you stopped telling me things about other people. I don't mean to not sound empathetic. I'm an empathetic person, Otis. But right now, I'm focused on saving Sophie and maybe those guys in the Jeep with the machine gun. So, are you here? Where'd you go, Sophie? Oh, I lost Sophie. Come on, Sophie.
Come on! Follow me! Come on! Come on!
Good, come on.
Come on!
Anyway, I have a lot on my plate, Otis. I do not need you phoning me every few minutes. All right, let's talk here, Otis.
Yeah,
I did, Otis. Here.
Good.
I'm going to keep that. And I'm going to make a photo collage, and it's going to say, people who have annoyed me during the zombie apocalypse. And you'll be on page one, Otis. Oh, here, cutscene. Let's listen to this.
So that's what Dr. Barnaby said, huh?
The old coot's not dumb. He wants us to call for help first. We gotta line out or what?
The signal's being blocked. I can't even contact HQ on the emergency line.
So, if we want to get our hands on Dr. Barnaby, we're gonna have to secure a way out of here ourselves. All right, we've got to deal with the situation we've been handed. The boneheads back at HQ might be working on something too.
There's a helicopter coming. 3 days from now. At noon, it's my ride.
Is your ride reliable?
Absolutely. That's how I plan on getting out of here.
All right, then. I'll see to it that the DHS picks up the charter fee. Can we take Dr. Barnaby as well?
Sure. As long as you tell me what's going on.
Okay. I'll tell you what you want to know. Later. We have more pressing business right now. If we have to wait here for 3 days, we'll need supplies. Water, blankets and the like. We'll get Dr. Barnaby here tomorrow morning. I want you to keep an eye on the monitors.
And there we go. We have done case one. Good. Hey, Jesse. That's a nice TV you've got there. I gotta find the washroom.
What's happened?
Here we go. Nope.
All right.
Well, I can save by laying down, but that's not as fun.
Happened?
Who's talking?
All right. Why, thank you.
Man, you saved my life. Perfect.
I'm glad you're happy about that. So, we're flying out, but are we taking all these people we're saving?
Good. Good.
I understand.
Everyone is crying. I'm going to save just by laying down.
Okay.
I know that's not the way I promised that I would save. But Frank needs to rest just as much as he needs to pee. And, you know, we have been playing for a little while. I've got to go. And also, I would be very, very upset if I died and I lost all of that.
All right.
Because, you know, that wasn't the best gameplay that you've ever seen on the internet. But it was certainly gameplay that you've seen on the internet.
All right.
And I do not want to do all that again.
Yeah.
Let's put on some different clothes.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily love the jacket look.
Yeah.
I mean, I like his leather jacket, but this is like, I mean, the 90s were a weird time. Sorry, the 2006s were a weird time. 90s were a weird time too. 2006 though, it was a lot like the 90s, but 6 years later. And here we go. I'm going to save again. So next time I start playing, I'll have the cool outfit. So I'm going to go camera two. Thank you very much for tuning in. This has been some Dead Rising 1 gameplay. If you didn't catch the start of the stream, Dead Rising 1, Dead Rising 2, and Dead Rising 2 Off the Record are now available on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and Steam. They are updated to HD resolution graphics, and they have a much better frame rate because modern systems can handle older games pretty well. So we're at 60 frames per second for all three titles. They're all available now. You can buy them digitally worldwide. You can also buy Dead Rising and Dead Rising 2 on disc in North America. Dead Rising is out on disc already. Dead Rising 2 will be out on disc in North America on September 27th. Worldwide, including North America, which is part of the world, they're all out now digitally. So you can buy them on the Xbox Store, on the PSN network, or on Steam. Thank you very much for tuning in. I'm going to show a couple trailers just to get you hyped, both for the re-release Dead Rising 10th Anniversary Editions that we've been showing off and will continue showing off over the next couple of weeks, as well as for Dead Rising 4, which is coming out December this year. It's almost here. We're working hard. Everyone but me is working hard because I have no actual skills. So they're like, go upstairs and play video games on the internet and let us do the actual work of making video games. So here we go. I'm going to play two trailers for you. One is the Black Friday kind of cinematic trailer that we released this week for Dead Rising 4. And the other is the launch trailer for the Dead Rising 10th Anniversary Editions. So thank you again for tuning in. And we'll be back in different venues, different forums. Follow our Facebook page. This is our Capcom Vancouver page, but there's also the Dead Rising Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram. We have a Twitch channel, which we usually broadcast these on. This time I just wanted to experiment with just using Facebook and just interacting with the Facebook fans on the Capcom Vancouver site. And thank you very much, and I hope to see you again later.
Oh, Christmas tree.
Beaten alive by zombies?
You're crazy. This isn't a game.
Looks like you're a zombie chow now.
You die out there, and we'll have to leave it to the devil to sort you out.